Ireland Baldwin defends Hailey and Justin Bieber after fans chant, Selena Gomez, at 2021 Met Gala. Ireland said cousin Hailey Baldwin and her husband Justin Bieber are one of the happiest and most in love couples I've ever gotten the chance to be around. Ireland Baldwin is defending cousin Hailey Baldwin and her famous husband, Justin Bieber. After a TikTok went viral of fans chanting, Selena Gomez, when the couple arrived at the Met Gala on Monday, the model, whose parents are Alec Baldwin and Kim Basinger, clapped back in the comment section. Selena Gomez fans camped outside the Met trying to ruin Justin and Hailey's red carpet moment, text over the TikTok says. While the caption reads, disgusting, with several hashtags, many TikTok users slammed the people in the video, calling the situation sad and disrespectful. That's not nice. True fans know Selena would not like that, one person wrote. Gomez and Bieber dated on and off from 2010 to 2018. Ireland added, they're one of the happiest and most in love couples I've ever gotten the chance to be around. They don't care about them, with a laughing face emoji. The unfortunate interaction fell on Baldwin and Bieber's third wedding anniversary, coincidentally on the same day as the Met Gala. The model revealed the sweet detail in a behind-the-scenes style video uploaded to her YouTube video on Tuesday, which documents her fittings and glam process for the annual benefit. This is probably the most last minute I've ever fit my dress, Baldwin shared at the beginning of the clip. Luckily, the black Saint Laurent column dress fit like a glove at her first fitting in Brooklyn, NY. During the session, Baldwin and stylist Carla Welch went back and forth with accessories as they experimented with two very different vibes. Grace Kelly inspired versus a more natural look reminiscent of Los Angeles style in the 1980s. I'm debating on the gloves because I'm trying to decide if the hair should be down or up. I've never worn my hair down at the Met, she explained. It's always been up every single year. I like it down with the dress. If I do it up, it would be like slick. Baldwin described her glam for past Met Galas as intense, to which a team member behind the camera responded, it's been an intense couple of themes, too, whereas this is like you're truly an American beauty. At the conclusion of the fitting, it's unclear which aesthetic Baldwin will choose, but she seems set on getting out of the car and walking the red carpet in her signature black sunglasses. During the clip, the star also shared, Justin and I have never gone to the Met together, and it's on our anniversary. The star then documented her glam trial day with makeup artist Mary Phillips and hairstylist Jen Atkin, explaining that it's important to have a test run because it's too chaotic to change directions on the day of the actual Met Gala. In the end, Baldwin and her team went with the more simple, all-American option, sans gloves. She added a Tiffany & Co. diamond choker for a touch of glamour. You just look cool, Atkin said of the effortless hairstyle and natural, glowy makeup. Bieber, meanwhile, donned a sleek black tuxedo by La Maison Drew, an extension of his Drew House label, painted sneakers and Jackie H jewelry. He walked the red carpet with a Drew House briefcase featuring the brand's signature smiley face logo. I feel like the Met is always just a very cool night to celebrate fashion, Baldwin told Kiki Palmer on the red carpet. We both love fashion, and we both love being able to celebrating designers. When asked about his style evolution over the years, Bieber explained, I think as I become more of an adult, things just started to evolve and change. I'm married now, so I think things just become more adult now. The theme of the 2021 Met Gala, which came after a canceled 2020 Met Gala and a postponed May date, was In America, a Lexicon of Fashion. Timothée Chalamet, Billie Eilish, Naomi Osaka and Amanda Gorman hosted the biggest night in fashion, Vogue confirmed in May. Honorary chairs for the evening were Tom Ford, Adam Mosseri and Vogue editor-in-chief Anna Wintour.